Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, WrestleZone would like to welcome you to tonight's live event. Before we begin, please be advised that all WrestleZone stars are professionally trained, so please do not copy or imitate anything you see here tonight. Please also be aware that WrestleZone is proud to provide entertainment suitable for all ages, and we ask that you refrain from using any inappropriate language this evening.
Hello and welcome to the WrestleZone podcast. I'm your host, as always, Billy. We have a bumper-filled edition of the podcast for you this week because we've got a lot to talk about. We have Blootoon Wrestling Extravaganza coming up on Saturday, the 24th of February at the Palace Hotel in Peterhead in association with the Peterhead Community Council. Tickets are still available. This is one of the few times I've been able to say that. The doors are open 6 p.m. for VIP, 6:30 for general, bell time 6:15 p.m. for VIP and 7 p.m. for general. Tickets are still available at ringsideworld.co.uk as of recording. We're going to talk about the whole card. We've got a lot to talk about. The full card lineup has been announced. Thankfully, I don't have to worry about trying to edit in anything afterwards. I've got the whole match announcement, all 7 matches, 6 main card, 1 VIP, and we've got lots to talk about when it comes to the road to Aberdeen Anarchy as well. I'm using my radio voice this morning, it seems. I'm excited. I'm hyped. I'm going to the show. Can't wait. I like going to Peterhead. I went there last year for another show, and I hadn't been there for a while before then. And it's got a great sweet shop. That's kind of my other than the wrestling, of course, my little focus there. Go up to see Bon Bon. I want to see the Brewtoon Tap Room as well. They've got some Murray Cup, like sour ale that I want to try. Obviously, I won't try when I'm going there because I'll be driving, but I want to at least try and see if I can grab some and take it home to sample as well. So I'm really excited to get to Peterhead. Really excited to see Blootoon Wrestling Extravaganza because initially I wasn't going to go to this one because we've got a lot of shows coming up, got a lot of things happening on in the old real life as well, that I thought, okay, right, I'll maybe give Peterhead a pass and we'll do Regal Rumble, we'll do Aberdeen Anarchy, and then kind of pick off the big ones, your Battle of Nations, Hijinks, Christmas Chaos for the end of the year, you know? But just from the end of Granite City Showdown, seeing things kind of being put into place and things that are happening, I thought, you know what? Peterhead's not that far away. I can go for the afternoon. I'd be back in the evening late. It'll be fine. It'll be all good. So that's what I've done. I got my ticket for Peterhead for Blootoon Wrestling Extravaganza. And we're going to go through the lineup. Before I go any further, in case you think, oh, dude, I don't want to hear the preview. I just want to hear what the big news is and all that kind of stuff. March 23rd to 24th, Comic-Con Scotland Aberdeen at P&J Live. You can see some WrestleZone action. I'll repeat all this at the end. Tickets, it comes as part of your ticket for Comic-Con Scotland Aberdeen, so go find out more. I will see if I'll get the address for the end outro bit as well. You go to Ringside World as well, get your tickets for March 30th, the Regal Rumble, taking place at Curl Aberdeen, and March 11th, Aberdeen Anarchy at the Rich Energy Arena. Tickets are available for that as well on ringsideworld.co.uk. And if you go to Aberdeen Anarchy this year on May 11th, you'll get to see Gangrel. Gangrel is going to be on the show. I was going through what he'd won in WWE, and I was realizing he had actually, I thought he was European champion at one point, but he had that, he was supposed to win it, but that wasn't the case at the end of the day against X-Pac. But Gangrel, that man, but as someone who's a huge Hardy Boys fan, that's kind of probably as close as I'm going to get in the near future to a Hardy Boy. I mean, I met Lita as well, thanks to Monopoly events, and it was hosted by Scotty Swift, that Q&A, remember rightly. But yeah, so getting to see Gangrel, that's quite a cool thing that you'll be able to do. I'm going to try and get hold of Gangrel before Aberdeen Anarchy. Might not happen, you know, I don't have much luck when it comes to the interviewing side of things, but I'm going to try and get a word from Gangrel before Aberdeen Anarchy about this show and about coming to Scotland, because you're supposed to wrestle in Aberdeen a few years ago, but things didn't pan out for another promotion. So I'll be excited to see Gangrel finally make it to Aberdeen and Rich Energy Arena. I'm hearing rumblings, I'm hearing rumours that it's going to be fully opened as well. So I'm excited to see what a full Rich Energy Arena is going to look like, because in January for Granite City Showdown, it was really great. It was about half full because it was only open half of the hall, and that was totally cool. So to see what they can do with a whole hall, if that happens, because again, this is all just through the rumor mill. I'll be excited to see how that looks, the spectacle, and get the old you know, the old montage, get my phone just going across the venue to see it. So let's look at the show there. We're looking at Blootoon Wrestling Extravaganza. Tickets are still available, Ringside World. Go and get a ticket for this, because even though it's one of these, you know, there's this thing that you go around, you got your big shows, you got usually your Showdown in January, you get Rumble, you got Rapid Anarchy, you got Battle of the Nations, Halloween Hijinks, and Christmas Chaos. That's kind of your big shows for WrestleZone. And then you got these littler shows that take place at like Ellen, Peterhead, like this one, or as I keep banging on about, Mr. P, I am Mr. Patterson, I should say. I'm still put out there. Get a show in Keith. Towards the end of the year. That's cool. Towards the end of the year, get a show in Keith. I want to take my son to a WrestleZone show, and Keith is just the prime place to do it, just because it's perfect. Because it'll be two. It means we'll be close by if he has a meltdown. It's all good. That is the prep. You know, I'll be the only one there. So that's not really selling it to you, I'm sure, Mr. Patterson. But I'm just saying, Keith. I don't know if Longmore Hall is still available. Bucky. Bucky would be even better, actually. Let's go Bucky. If you can get Bucky, his grandparents are there. Fantastic. Let's go for that. You know, Keith is great. Bucky might be better. Anyway, WrestleZone Blootoon Wrestling Extravaganza. Let's take a look at the match card we have for the show.
2023 didn't exactly end well for Chris Archer. You know what? 2024 hadn't exactly started great either. But I can give you one reason why that is. It's young punks like Evan Young, young punks like Oliver Green, trying to make their name off of Chris Archer, the established veteran here at WrestleZone. You know what? Chris Archer's only got one way he can solve this. 24th of February, Peterhead at the Palace Hotel. Lace up your boots, boys, because I want you, Oliver Green, I want you, Evan Young, in a triple threat match. And we'll see on that night just how good you really are. Chris Archer's going to show you exactly why he is the man here in WrestleZone.
And with that opening ramble over, we're going to look at the VIP pre-show match for Blootoon Wrestling Extravaganza. You heard Chris Archer there. He feel disrespected in WrestleZone due to these youngins. These guys who are facing. Chris Archer's taking on Oliver Green and I'm sorry, Evan. I was about to call you Elvin Young. So I apologize for a meme idea that's going to pop into your brain for that. So it's taking on Chris Archer, Oliver Green, Evan Young, triple threat match. Green and Young have picked up wins over Chris Archer recently in either triple threat or singles competition. Archer wants a hold of both of them. Triple threat match, pair out the challenge. Here it is. Chris Archer's been kind of like languishing in the VIP pre-show since his return. After Avery Anarchy last year, he made it onto the main show on Grand State Showdown for the returning Evan Young, and Evan Young picked up the win out of nowhere with a quick roll-up as well. So Archer's incensed. Archer wants a hold of these two young guys, Oliver Green and Evan Young, and his wish has been granted. So we've got a triple threat going into this. Oliver Green's have got great momentum going right now. Fantastic momentum, considering at Grand State Showdown he won a triple threat involving Tommy Raiden and Zach Dynamite, pinning Tommy Raiden following a Zach Dynamite kill shot. So Green's got a lot of momentum. Evan Young, just back from a long layoff, got a win over Chris Archer at Grand City Showdown. Archer's the only one here. I'm trying to remember. I don't think he's picked up a win since for a year, maybe, in WrestleZone. Come to think of it, I will probably do some research in the break and correct myself in the next match if I'm wrong. But I don't think he's won a match since Train Academy show, and that was against Oliver Green. So Archer's got a lot to prove here. You know, he's been in WrestleZone for a long time. He's been involved in WrestleZone. He's won championships. He's been in high-profile matches. with the likes of Devon Dudley. You know, so he's got a big what's the word? I can't think of the word now. But he's got quite the number of accolades in WrestleZone, and now he's maybe expected to pass the torch, but he's not willing to pass the torch. I don't know if that's possibly into play there with all these young talents coming through the training academy, like your Oliver Green, like Evan Young, like your Tommy Raiden, like your Ronan Kings and your Conor Malloys. But Archer still has a lot in the tank. He still puts on some of the most consistently great matches in WrestleZone. So maybe he feels, not that this is a th possibly the thing, but maybe he feels that all these young guys coming through, he's starting to get pushed out of favor in WrestleZone, and with that, he's not willing to let it go. He's wanted to fight and prove that he is still as good as he is, as good as he was, as good as he is in WrestleZone. He's going to take out on these two guys to prove it. Predictions, I try not to do predictions because I'm really, really bad at it for WrestleZone especially. But this is going to be a really fast-paced match. Green is coming a bit, is getting more and more confident as his year. This is February will March will mark a year since he made his debut in WrestleZone for the Regal Rumble. So this is kind of maybe seeing that year how he's progressed, and I think in ring he's progressed fantastically. I just want to see a bit more of that confidence exude in his body language and his face a bit more. Evan Young came back full of bull of bluster. That's not a phrase, I'm sorry. Him coming back seems confident. Got a big win over Chris Archer, former Tri-Couch champion, former tag team champion. Hopefully that sets him up for his year ahead in WrestleZone, and we'll see how that plays out in the future. And I mean, all these guys are looking for a bit of momentum. Momentum is always the key when I do these podcasts, and you'll notice that if you go back and listen to other preview shows, that I'll use the word momentum quite a lot, because we're into Regal Rumble season, we're into Anarchy season. These guys are all needing that momentum to go into that 25-man Regal Rumble match, and for the winner, the victor goes into the main event of Aberdeen Anarchy. We'll have our five predicted possible picks for winning on the website on swnscotland.com in the near future. I'm absolutely certain, and I'll probably like ramble about it in the preview show for Regal Rumble itself. But this is all about momentum. Get a win here, Blootoon Wrestling Extravaganza. Just push yourself forward into Regal Rumble. Get the win there. You're golden. You're in the main event. You're either against Lost by Aspen, or if possibility, he might not be the champion by the time that it comes round at Regal Rumble, and you'll have Lost by Aspen in there as well. It's just, you don't know what's going to happen. That's the best thing. That's the best thing about the Regal Rumble, especially because you can kind of have your five picks and then it go wildly wrong. But I think I've got a pretty good record the last few years. I think I've got I may have I think I've picked out I've picked at least one. Well, I've picked the winner in my five picks each year. I mean, if I pick five, and it used to be a 20 man, I was 1 in 4 getting it right anyway. And this year, 1 in 5. So I like those odds. Anyway, yes, triple threat match. Chris Archer looking for a measure of revenge against these young bucks, and Oliver Green and Evan Young looking to punch a little bit more momentum into their year to push themselves forward into the Regal Rumble. Well, this is going to be a good one. Next up, TV's Omar Muhammad taking on Zach Dynamite, the Aberdonian ace. A match that I am absolutely buzzing for. I asked Mrs. SWN, Kelly, she asked what the matches were on the show. She will be appearing. She'll be coming with me to the Regal Rumble. That's the plan anyway. So because she hasn't been to WrestleZone show for ages, and she needs some wrestling fill. She needs to watch some people beat each other up. That's kind of the play of the day here. So I told her last match on the main card announced was TV's over Muhammad against Zach Dynamite. She was like, "Oh, Omar." She was didn't even hesitate. Sorry, Zach. But Omar was her pick in that match. This is a match that I've wanted to see. I missed it. It took place at Trinity Center Takeover. October last, was that October last year? God, was it last year? Wow. That can't be right. Was it 2022? Ah, it's okay. It's not important at this stage. I think it was. Anyway, sorry, I'm getting myself distracted there. But this is a match that took place just while I was in Aberdeen, right about the town. I came back and I missed it. I think I saw the tail end of it, possibly. It was Zach Dynamite defending the Undisputed Wrestling Championship. So it must be 2022. He was defending the Wrestling Undisputed Championship against Omar Mohamed, and Dynamite tapped out Omar. And it's been a long time since then. 2022, October 2022. And now we're in February 2024. So that's a good big gap of time. Is that 14 months, something like that? So a big gap of time that's seen Omar have go through his trials and tribulations with the Warriors against low-life entities, having to say goodbye to Scotty Swift, say hello to Mr. WrestleZone, and then see Mr. WrestleZone get absolutely obliterated at Christmas Chaos by the Foundation of the Future. So this is his first chance, really, to get a hold of anyone for the Foundation of the Future since Christmas Chaos. Chaos, he wasn't there. He missed the attack because he was injured in his match previously, and was being taken away to the hospital to get checked over. I think it was his knee, if I remember rightly. So we had that. And then at Grand City Showdown, he wanted a hold of someone from the Foundation of the Future, but was put into a match with Captain Alan Sterling instead by Mr. Patterson. So now he gets a hold of somebody from the Foundation of the Future, and that being Zach Dynamite, who really instigated the attack when it came to Mr. WrestleZone at Christmas Chaos as well, because he invoked the name of Scotty Swift. And this was in the same venue, the Instant Community Centre, where Scotty Swift had to retire due to losing to Brian Tucker. So that's a big name to invoke. And Mr. WrestleZone, he knows his history. He knows his WrestleZone history. He's Mr. WrestleZone. He couldn't take any more and double leg take down Dynamite. And that was where the attack started. That's where the attack ended, with Mr. WrestleZone being pile driven by a triple team pile driven to the mat.
This is Jim! Because Scotty Swift would be such a gutless coward! Whoa!
So Omar is looking for some revenge there. So that's a little bit against Omar's kind of, credo. That's not a word. I'm making up words here in this podcast. When it comes to wrestling, he's used the sensational scenes, the good, fun-loving time. But this is coming into a match with Zach Dynamite, who is one of the best wrestlers in the country. He's called the Armadillian Ace. This isn't a moniker that you just throw around. He is one of the best wrestlers in the country, and he's coming up against Omar, who, like I say, he does have the fun-loving stuff. He does do the clapperboard and the fun dancing and all that kind of stuff and the great outfits. But I know, seeing his reaction after Scotty Swift being retired and seeing the rage that builds in the eyes of Omar Mohamed, Dynamite's not going to have an easy night. And this is a different guy from who we faced at Trinity Center Takeover. This is an absolute different guy. And we're going to see that, and I hope Dynamite... I say I hope Dynamite's ready. He tagged Mr. WrestleZone. I don't know. Omar Mohamed is going to have to... He's going to have to really contain his anger at some point, because who's refereeing it? If it's either Dennis or if it's Mikey, or if we've got one of the guys from the training academy who's been trained to do refereeing duties that particular evening, he's going to really have to keep a lid on that anger, so he's not disqualified and wasting that opportunity to take out Zach Dynamite, because this might be one of his only chances. The Foundation are in the building. They've got a match a little later, whether it's later on or before, I don't know. They've got a match on the show. And so he's really got to either take advantage of the opportunity that possibly may be presented if the Foundation, for whatever reason, cannot come out, they cannot interfere, because that's been their MO for a long time. The Foundation of the Future, they are a trio, and they're as good as brothers when it comes to having each other's back. Good or bad, that's for you to decide. So Omar's really got to take advantage of this to get a hold of Zach Dynamite and try and gain a little measure of revenge for Mr. WrestleZone as well. So we've got Dynamite trying to crack the foundations of WrestleZone. He keeps doing it. We'll talk about it a little bit more in the tag team match that we've got. I'll move it up. I'll go into that one next. So we got Dynamite here. He probably doesn't even... We've seen Dynamite enough now. He probably doesn't even care about Omar Mohammed. This is probably just another Saturday for him. He's coming in just to batter someone. It could have been anyone in front of him. So Omar's coming in here with all the bluster and the rage and all that. And Dynamite's just like going, right, I'm just going to batter you. And, I've got more important things to think about. So that's a lot of dynamics going on here that I'm making up in my brain here when it comes to this particular match. But it's what I'm very much excited for. I'm glad I missed it back at Trinity Center Takeover. So I'm really happy that I get to see it now, especially with the growth of both wrestlers since that time. Oh, it's going to be a really good one.
William Sterling, you are a marked man by the Foundation of the Future because you are an idiot. You're an egg-sucking dog. You are the roadblock to our success. You are the roadblock to us getting to the top of WrestleZone. You deserved everything that we were going to give to you. But then, a little rat-faced Damien decided to show up.
Very, very brave, Damien. The last time you got involved in the Foundation's business, Zack Dynamite took your precious championship away from you. And now in Peterhead, we've got a reunion. WrestleZone's old guard trying to contend with today. We're not going to stand for the two of you using us to stay relevant. And Damien, this time you're not going to lose a championship. No, the both of you are going to lose so much more when we tear you apart and leave you stranded in Peterhead. Forever, the Foundation.
Foundation of the Future, the three of you boys must be delusional. If you think for one second that you're going to run around WrestleZone causing nothing but chaos and people aren't going to stand up to you.
See this here? This is proudly displayed at the WrestleZone Training Academy because Sterling Oil helped build this company. You see, there is no future without a past. And long before you guys came to WrestleZone, Damien, myself, Alan, we ran this place. And now, you want to talk about being disrespected? Boo hoo to you. You want to be disrespected? Well, you're going to be disrespected in Peterhead because Stone Oil is here to collect a debt.
You want to talk about foundations in Peterhead? You come face to face with the real foundations of WrestleZone.
So I've moved it up the list. I was going to do this one a little bit later on, but let's talk about the Foundation of the Future, Ryan Riley and Bruiser Brad Evans taking on the team of William Sterling and Damien. So let's back Granite City Showdown. So went back to Granite City Showdown. In the pre-show, William Sterling and Damien defeated the Warriors Against Low Life Entities, Brian Tucker and Rhys Dawkins. Later on in the show, we had Foundation of the Future losing to the Outfit in their championship rematch over the tag team titles. They weren't happy. Dynamite came out. We thought, oh, maybe there's some tension in the Foundation. Not the case at all. The Foundation are still very strong, Foundation of the Future. And they felt disrespected by WrestleZone and by people that were involved in the decisions and runnings of WrestleZone. and calling out William Starling. So William Starling came out, and it was acknowledged that he's part of the management team at WrestleZone. And after a little bit of cajoling, a little bit of needling, William Starling got in the ring and was attacked and eventually saved by Damien as Starling had a chair wrapped around his knee. As you heard there, William Starling and Damien, they've been quite separate over the years after the fallout of Sterling Oil, after that incredible journey, that moment, what we saw. That was it. What was it? It was Regal Rumble of 2015, that we got to see Damien leave Sterling Oil when he super kicked Shawn Johnson on the same night he had a match with Tyler Bate. It was just a phenomenal night. I'm forgetting the year, but I think it was 15. I'm going to say 15, unconfidently. Yes. No. Oh no, I'm turned into Ed Leslie. Anyway, right. So we had that. And they haven't really been. Haven't really interacted since, I don't think. Not often, if any, interactions since then, since the fallout of Sterling Oil. So Grand City Showdown saw them reunite. They're now seem to be using the Sterling Oil name a little bit more as well, in William Sterling's words there. Sterling acknowledged that without Sterling Oil, there would be a foundation of the future. They are the foundations of WrestleZone. Something that I've been picking up on since Christmas Chaos and Granite City Showdown, talking about Foundation of the Future, looking to crack the foundations of WrestleZone itself and targeting the old guard, if you want to call it that, in WrestleZone. So Starling and Damien are reunited and it feels so good, and they're taking on the Foundation of the Future. I don't fancy Sterling Oil's chances. And it sounds really bad to say this because I'm a big fan of Damien. And, you know, William Starling has his moments. He's always been kind of the Starling bad guy. But I don't... Foundation of the Future are one of the best teams in the country, you know? Ryan Riley, Bruiser Brad Evans, you know, sometimes they get a little bit overconfident at times when it comes to it because they're just such a well-oiled machine. Sometimes a rag gets thrown in there, you know, and knocks the machine process. I don't know. I've always had an office job. I don't know how machines work, but you can't just throw away a random team against. I mean, seemingly random because they haven't really united a lot over the last few years, but you can't really throw in Sterling and Damien against a team like the Foundation of the Future and expect good news. You know, we might see some flickers of hope, but. It's really hard for me to go, I think Sterling and Damien might win, and that puts them in an underdog position, which is not something that Damien's often in, you know. It's just there's going to be, again, some measure of revenge out there for Sterling and Damien, which could power them through, get that adrenaline rush going against the Foundation of the Future. But when you're coming up against a team, two-time WrestleZone Tag Team Champions, that have dominated the tag team landscape over the last few years in WrestleZone, it's really hard to bet against them at the same time. So yeah, it's really going to be down to how much adrenaline can you muster, or are we going to see maybe a difference maker? Maybe we're going to see a return at Peterhead. Maybe we're going to see maybe Mr. WrestleZone, if he doesn't appear for Omar, maybe he'll return here to try and gain a little bit of revenge. From all accounts that I've heard, Mr. WrestleZone seems to have disappeared. He has went into the night after his triple team pile driver. So I'm very intrigued how this one's going to go and how Sterling and Damien, though they've got the experience on their hands, whether they're going to be able to kind of rally all that together against the youth and tag team experience of the Foundation of the Future. I mean, saying all that, William Starling, record-holding WrestleZone Tag Team Champion. I think he's 7-time Tag Team Champion. Damien's held it a couple times as well. So these guys have got tag team experience. But the Foundation, they're such a well... I've already used well-oiled machine, but they're such a well-knit unit. It's hard to really bet against them. But surprises, wrestling. It's wrestling at the end of the day. Surprises happen. We could see Damian and William Starling use that experience edge to their advantage. Maybe take a couple shortcuts. Foundation are okay with doing that. So why would William and Damian do that as well? Who knows? That's the interest.
Going. Yes, big one.
You ready to start training?
Yeah, ready?
Yeah, come with me.
Right, let's go.
I don't need the ring yet. It's fine.
Okay.
Right. So, I've been watching back some of your matches.
Yeah.
I think I figured out what part of the problem is. It's maybe your stature, your build.
Okay.
I get it, you're built for speed and agility and whatever. I think we need to put some beef on.
Okay.
So, in case of that, I've got these. Look, let's get started with these. This is Vago's meal plan.
Vago, with all due respect, I'm just about to start training. I mean, is it really that time to just start eating the cheeseburgers and the...
Well, is it just cheeseburgers you've got in here? Cheeseburgers? Look, you've got your carbs, your protein, you've got your dairy in there. I mean, there's a couple of your veg. I mean, there's anything the grown boy needs in there. So... Let's start that. And obviously, you can't just eat cheeseburgers. You're going to need someone to wash that down, man.
Okay.
So.
Whoa. Okay.
I mean,
it'd be big again, with all due respect, I'm not the type of person to just.
No, you're not. Don't really... Just I'm not asking you to drink all four, but yeah. If you get. That's what we need. Build you up. Get some of that muscle on you.
But yeah.
That's Mr. P calling. Okay. Just 2 seconds. Hi, Dave. Yeah, we're actually at the academy now. We're just getting stuck into some training. Yeah, it's going well. Don't worry about it. You just keep sorting the matches out, and I'll keep going with the training with you and Tommy here, and we'll get sorted out. Yeah. Yeah, good. All right, cool. Catch you later. Yeah. So, like I said, you get starting that.
Okay.
Get that on you. Like I said, don't drink all the beer. Just one or two, just to get started.
All right,
and then. We'll get going with the treatment.
Okay.
Thank God I found such a comfortable place to lie down, because it's so very, very cold. I'm so cold without that jacket, without that garment, without that shawaddy waddy. I love the way it felt on my skin, Uma. Uma, I love the way it felt on my skin, and I will have it. It will be mine. So I looked for the nearest harbour. I looked where I could get there with a boat. And you know what? Peterhead has a lovely harbour. It has a terrific harbour. And I will be there. There.
Tommy.
Hello. Vago.
How's it going?
Peterhead.
Right. Take a seat.
Okay.
Before we start physical training.
Okay.
This is what we're doing today. Before we work on the body, we work on the mind.
Okay.
So. Heavy metal history. That's what we're working on today.
Okay. What does this have to do with... Does that have to do something to lead up to physical training, or...?
Who's the coach? I'm the coach. Yeah. Ears open. So, early 70s, heavy metal. Black Sabbath, Judas Priest. There's your pioneers. There's what defines heavy metal. From there, there's a whole multitude of things that we can go into there.
Okay.
Basically, that's your gist, Tommy. I mean, obviously we can go into a lot more detail, but we've been here long enough. So, you're all being fast, being quick.
Yeah.
So here we go. Speed metal. That's what we're focused on. Speed metal. In fact, not that that's a good name for a tag team. Speed metal. We'll keep that.
I think that's okay. I like that.
So, let's get some listening doing.
Yes.
We'll see how you like it.
Okay.
So, Razor. Speed metal. Here we go.
All right.
You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready. Let's hear it.
Next up. Okay, right. Okay, let's break this one down. So, Captain Alan Sterling versus Mickey Vago. Vago, I'm assuming, will have Tommy Raiden, but who we're seeing, who you will have seen in this episode, who's getting trained by Mickey Vago. It's going interestingly. I don't know if that's good or bad, but it's going interestingly. I don't know if how much wrestling's being taught to Tommy Raiden, but he's definitely getting told about... I mean, I'm very, very confused about the diet, because we've seen Mickey Vago. He's in tremendous shape, and it's all because of beer and cheeseburgers. And to be honest, if I knew that, then what am I missing? Probably cardio. Yeah, I might be. That might be the thing I'm missing. But so he's teaching Tommy his ways, the hooligan ways, heavy metal hooligan ways, and it's going interestingly. I said we'd have to get a comment of Tommy about that. So we've got that. Vigo's dealing with that. Captain Alan Sterling is seemingly still obsessed with Omar Muhammad's Shawadi Wadi. Not Shivani. Shawadi Wadi. So we've got that going on. I don't think these two guys particularly have a focus on each other when it comes to this match. But I mean, that could change. By the time that I've finished recording this bit, a video will probably go out on Twitter where Vago's put out that he's really focused on this match and he's really to batter Alan Sterling. Vago's beat Sterling before. You know, he beat him for the Tri-Counties Championship. So Vago's kind of... I don't know. I don't know if these two guys really, like, have a thought on the other at this particular moment when it comes into this match. Again, this could just be a momentum builder. This is your... building that meter in the corner so you can get hit a L2, R2, and then release your finisher, so to speak. Oh, that sounded filthy. So, yeah, these two guys probably don't have much thought on the other. We're not even sure if Alan Sterling has any thoughts, full stop, the end. So, I don't know how this is going to... I think it's going to be the one where you watch it and go, I have no idea what's happening, but I like it. You know, that kind of match where you watch it going, Captain Alan's not really focusing on Mickey Vago. Vago's just there maybe just to like I said, build that momentum, show Tommy Raiden some moves, and maybe do some on the spot, on the fly, teaching on the night. But this is one that I'm just like, I saw it now just to go, I'm going to really like this. I have no idea how it's going to go, you know? You watch it and go, this is weird. This is odd. So, but I mean, you come into that with some sort of expectation when you see a Captain Alan Sterling match anyway. So yeah, I don't have a lot to say in the preview of this particular one because this doesn't seem like these two really focus on each other. We've got Captain Alan wanting another crack at TV's Omar Muhammad. We've got Vago teaching Tommy Raiden. Both of them will probably be in the Regal Rumble. And that's about it. You know, there's not a lot. Sometimes matches are put together on shows. Sometimes they're thrown on, and there's a little bit of history here, like the Tri-Counties Championship. But generally, they're just going to happen, and we're just going to sit and enjoy it, you know, at the Palace Hotel in Peterhead on February 24th. Tickets still available at Ringside World. Go get a ticket. It's gonna be a fun match. I just don't have a lot of information to throw at you for this particular one. So let's move on to the next one. So into the back half of our preview here, we have a non-title tag team match with the Outfit, Ted O'Keefe and Murphy take on the Warriors against low-life entities, Rhys Dawkins and Brian Tucker. Possibly this is going to be the first podcast I'll be able to say Rhys Dawkins and Brian Tucker without messing it up. Who knows? We're all scared. We've got tag team match. So really, I think over at AEW, they've got things like title eliminators. You know, if Warriors against the life entities pick up a win over the Outfit, then that puts them into contention to get a title match and further down the line. And that's pretty much it we've got going on here. So the Outfit picked up a big win at Grand City Showdown when they retained against former champions the Foundation of the Future in a really great match. They got beaten hard in that match. They had a very, very back and forth. It was very either way could have picked up the win and taken the titles home, but it was the Outfit at the end of the day that retained WrestleZone Tag Team Championships. Coming against Wally's, Tucker and Dawkins, they had a pretty good 2023. And then it really kind of the wheels started like falling off a little bit, and they haven't really recovered yet. They had the four way at Christmas Chaos, which they lost. Then they had Granite City Showdown and lost to William Starling and Damien. So I can see why management didn't give them a title match. They didn't put them into a title contention, but a win against the outfit, O'Keefe and Murphy, definitely puts them into that position. So another quite quick preview here when it comes to it. But this is a lot of teams that earlier, or last year, early 2023, we wouldn't have seen the outfit against teams like this because they weren't really wrestling for the fans, you know? They were looking just after number one for the titles, not really engaging with the audience as a, like for cheers or for any sort of adulation. So this is one of the tag teams in WrestleZone that they haven't faced, and one of the teams that the foundation ran down as well, interestingly enough. And so they faced in that four way at Christmas Chaos. So we'll see what they're like and how they fare two on two. Tucker's got the experience as tag team wrestler for a while now, for multi-time tag team champion. Rhys Dawkins has been under the tutelage and guidance of Brian Tucker a little bit here. Rhys Dawkins being one of the guys that I'm still forever doing one of these one to watch lists, and like I've started it, and it's just there's a lot of people that I want to fit in somewhere in here in the list. But Rhys Dawkins was one of my first names I put in there. I think he's just really good, you know. While he's still part of Wally's Warriors Against Low Life Entities, I don't know if it hurts or if it helps or hurts it, but it's still Tucker and Dawkins. Interesting team, but they throw teams off their game. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. And the outfit's got to kind of be careful of that. A younger team, when it comes to experience, when you count Brian Tucker especially, it's makes for an interesting lineup, an interesting perspective match. So yeah, Tucker comes with a lot of experience. Him and Dawkins haven't teamed as long as the outfit. No, that'd be a lie. That'd be a lie, because O'Keefe and Murphy only reunited at Regal Rumble last year. So they've got a little bit of an edge as a team as well for that experience. But out for coming with the championships, they're coming in with the championships well, not even advantage. They're not on the line. It's a non-title match. But if they pick up a win over Tucker and Dawkins, then it puts them back in the line, further back in the line with the foundation. But if the Warriors against low life entities win, then that puts them into title contention straight away. So a lot on the line here, really, in this non-title match for the outfit and for Tucker and Dawkins. Yeah, so that makes for interest and intrigue. So before we look into the final two matches on the show, I want to remind you about upcoming shows coming for WrestleZone. So not only is February 24th at the Palace Hotel in association with Peterhead Community Council presenting Blootoon WrestleZone, oh God, I'm all over the place, Blootoon Wrestling Extravaganza. I've also got March 23rd to 24th at Comic Con Scotland Aberdeen at P&J Live as part of your Comic Con ticket. I go get see that. March 30th at Regal Rumble at Curragh Aberdeen. We'll have a preview of that show coming up in March. And on May 11th, Aberdeen Anarchy featuring Gangrel taking place at the Rich Energy Arena in Aberdeen as well. So there's a lot coming up. It's Aberdeen Anarchy season. It's coming, baby. And I'm so excited because this is my favorite time of the year. And the wrestling calendar is we're going to get see a lot of wrestling coming up and a lot of fun wrestling in the northeast of Scotland. So for the last two shows, for Eagle Rumble and Aberdeen Anarchy, head over to ringsideworld.co.uk and you can find out how to get your tickets, where to get your tickets. Tickets are still available. As of recording, they're still available for Blootoon Wrestling Extravaganza as well. So get your ticket. I've already spoken about what was it, the four main show, one VIP match that's coming up, and we've got two more matches to look at before we wrap up and I go do other things. I don't know what yet. It's still quite early in the day. I haven't decided what I'm going to do. Maybe I'll go get lunch. Who knows? Anyway, so yeah, quick reminder of those. Let's look at the last two matches.
Oh, it's Caleb the loser! Long time no see, buddy. When was the last time I seen you? Was it Granite City Showdown? What happened then? Did Flippy and Drippy beat Skullbrawl? Yes! And what were you doing? Last I seen you, you were looking up at the lights at the end of the night. And what are you going to be doing in a few weeks when I come for that Tri-Counties Championship? What are you going to be doing at the end of the night then? You're going to be looking up at the lights when I take that Tri-Counties from you, baby. Go skull, skull, skull. Toodles.
So the last two matches are kind of intertwined, but we're going to start with the WrestleZone Tri-Counties Championship match here. And we've got Caleb Valhalla defending against Connor Malloy. So at Granite City Showdown, we saw the team of Flippy and Drippy, with it in, not and. I did write and quite a lot when I was doing previews of that. But Flippy and Drippy, Ronan King and Connor Malloy picked up a win over Skull Brawl by pinning Caleb Valhalla in the ring to win in the main event of Granite City Showdown, which was, I'm not going to say shocking, because King and Malloy are very good, but to see Skull Brawl fall, there you go, it's a little bit of rhyme in there, was a little bit of a shocking moment. These are two singles champions, this Tri-Counties champion and the Undisputed WrestleZone champion, in losing in the main event. And I think it's one of the first times Aspen's lost as well, which I'll talk about that in the next match. But to see Caleb pinned isn't something you see often in WrestleZone, you know? These two have a little bit of history, you know? Is my new catchphrase. I'm so sorry. So, back last year, Station Hotel Showdown. We were supposed to see... I forgot the match I was supposed to see. I think it was supposed to be... It was Caleb Valhalla. Caleb Valhalla versus Allen. There we go. It's Captain Allen Sterling versus Caleb Valhalla was the planned match. I think it was supposed to be for the WrestleZone Tri-Counties. No, can't it be? Because that was Vago and held at the time. I'm talking rubbish. Let's just reset. So, Station Hotel Showdown. We were supposed to see Captain Allen Sterling versus Caleb Valhalla, one of the most snake bit rivalries in recent WrestleZone times. Allen either was stuck on a ship somewhere, or had COVID, that was still going about. Couldn't attend, wasn't at the show. So Connor Malloy was pulled from the pre-show triple threat match and put into the opening match against Caleb Valhalla. This was phenomenal. It's one of the best matches I saw last year. If you go onto YouTube, I think it's on YouTube, go find it. You can find it with and without commentary, I think, as well, if you want to hear the lovely smooth tones of Jamie Chesser and Blue Thunder. But it was one of the best matches. And it's a match that you didn't expect to see, and it just was phenomenal. So fast forward, here we are, now to 2024. So that's a year since over a year since that match. Since then, we've seen Caleb win the Regal Rumble, become Tri-Counties champion, do all that kind of good stuff. Since then, for Connor, we saw him kind of a little bit of middling about, but then he won the guaranteed title shot, cashed it in at Christmas Chaos, lost to Aspen, and then united with Ronan King to form Flippy and Drippy in WrestleZone in the Northeast. So, a lot has happened for both these guys in that 12 months. And Connor Malloy has changed attitude. He's a little bit more sassy. He's a little bit more unhinged, people may say. And he's coming in with a lot to prove. Because as it was pointed out for Christmas Chaos, that nobody really thought he'd have a chance against Aspen. You know, I think the only person that did was Ronan King. And coming into that match, we were all resigned to the fact it was going to end two ways. One, Connor was going to lose. Two, Connor was going to get destroyed, you know? And with that being the case, I could see why the resentment grew. I could see why Connor would think, why should I bother? Why should I bother urging for support? Why should I bother wanting to get fans to clap and come on guys, you know, all that kind of stuff, when they don't think I have a chance of winning, You know, that's a really hard thing to digest. And for Ronan to be there to kind of pick him up and I don't want to say take him under his wing, because Connor's been around a little bit longer than Ronan, but to take him into his team Ronan, I don't know what the youngins call it, it's probably a word somewhere for something like that. It just manifested. What's the word that makes things grow? I'll go manifested. You can correct me if you want. Manifested resentment to the fans, resentment to WrestleZone for not believing in him, being the tag team guy with Crusher. That once Crusher retired, what was Connor? You know, we know what Connor can do in the ring. He's really great wrestler, fantastic wrestler. But it didn't seem like he was put into any trusted positions for titles. He was put into throwing in some tag matches, you know, with Bingo Balance. But, you know, I was going up against the Foundation of the Future. Like I said earlier, you can't just throw together a team to go against a team like the Foundation of the Future. He won that title shot ladder match, and well-deserved. It was a fantastic ladder match, and he well-deserved to have that shot. But he still... We didn't really believe that Connor could beat Aspen. I think I did in my preview, though, whether it was the road trip or on the WrestleZone podcast, I did have one of those feelings in the pit of my stomach. I thought, you know, Connor could win. You know, Connor might just win. It was a really outside shot, but that's by the by. It happened. Christmas Chaos happened. Grand City Showdown happened. We've got to see a new side of Connor Malloy, and he's coming up against Caleb Valhalla, the Tri-Counties champion, who won the title back in August at Battle of the Nations. So he's coming in for, what's that? 6 month reign of the title, and first title in WrestleZone, not looking to let go of it anytime soon. Connor's faced Valhalla, had a fantastic match with Valhalla. Maybe he's found a weakness. We don't know. We'll find out. I'm excited for it. I'm excited to see the rematch and see how these two have gone since Station Hotel.
It's murder or Aspen. The runner's gonna win the belt, baby. Gonna be WrestleZone champ from now. Oh, he knows. He's the goat. And so. He's going to win. If you think you're kicking out, he will prove you wrong. He'll take your breath away. Oh, he's just so strong. Hear me when I say, hey. It's murder of Aspen. Ronan's gonna win the belt, baby. Gonna be WrestleZone champ from now. It's murder of Aspen. You know you're gonna lose, baby. Gonna stomp your head into the ground.
And now time for your expected main event. I'm assuming it's for the Undisputed WrestleZone Championship. Those often go last. We've got Lost by Aspen defending against Ronan King in a match where I'd pegged this for an Abu Dhabi match. I didn't think this match would happen so soon. I thought we'd see Ronan go through the Rumble and we'd see this happen at Rich Energy Arena on May 11th. Tickets available for Abu Dhabi with Gangrel now in Risk Side World. I thought we would see this match a little bit later on, but we're seeing the fallout of Granite City Showdown, fallout from Christmas Chaos. We're seeing Skull Brawl and Flippy and Drippy battle again. Not a lot I could really add to the previous bit because these two matches are intertwined and connected in that way. But I will say that Aspen's coming in with Titanic Reign as Undisputed WrestleZone Champion. So it's now over a year as champion. I mean, he's going to It's going to take a lot to beat Damien's record, but there was a pandemic in the middle, in all fairness. But he's a titanic reign. Connor came close, but I don't think his reign really has had a lot of... I don't want to say problems. That's wrong. That's really disrespectful to everyone else. But his reign hasn't been in doubt. His matches have been quite conclusive a lot of the time. He's had some close calls with likes of Nikki Vago and Caleb Valhalla at Avenue Anarchy last year. But he seemed to take in these title matches in his stride. There hasn't been a lot of on that reign. I think Ronan King is a wild card. We saw his music video, if it's cleared through YouTube. If it hasn't, very awkward me saying this, but Ronan's confident. He's got a lot of friends as well, with likes of Conor Malloy, with Judas Grey. I mean, I mentioned him, he's not planned, scheduled, or announced for the show, as far as I'm aware. But he's got a little circle of cocky, young, I'm going to use Bucks again. I did it for the first match, I'm using it for the last match. And there's my doorbell. And we're back. I need an excuse to use that Brian Tucker bit anyway that I did. So yeah, we're talking about this main event here. So Skull Brawl lost the Grand City Showdown. Ronan and Aspen have kind of been a little bit on the outskirts of each other for a while. I remember, what was it? Was it Regal Rumble 2022? I think it was with the Joe Winners, that Ronan just liked to antagonize Aspen for quite a bit before the match itself, and we got to see Aspen deliver a lot of darkest lariats, chops, and what have you to Ronan King. And it's been a while, possibly since. Well, I say it'd be a while. They face each other at Christmas at Grand City Showdown. So, like I say, a lot of it I mentioned in the previous match, Strikeout Championship. But Ronan King, it shows the trajectory that he's been on since he debuted end of 2021, in that he is now in a main event match for the Undisputed WrestleZone Championship. He is ritually, he's cocky. You know, he's got all that just sheer cockiness and overconfidence. But you can't deny how good of a wrestler he is. You know, you come into this going, this is going to be a great match. It's going to be a fantastic match. And you just got to think, can Ronan do it? Can Ronan, with all that promises of murdering Aspen, with all those promises of the greatest of all time, the greatest 21-year-old wrestler in Scotland, 20. I am absolutely losing my mind here. I'm so excited for this. 20. He'll be the greatest 21-year-old wrestler next year, this year at some point as well. And he is that. He is really good. But Aspen's been around for a bit. You know, he's been around for a minute. Former Undisputed Champion, Tri-Couch Champion, Tag Team Champion, won the Regal Rumble. You know, he's won the Triple Crown / Grand Slam in WrestleZone. He has wrestled in death matches. He has pulled more pins out of his body than Ronan King has had hot meals. He has been around the block. He has beaten people. He has hurt people. He has been beaten. He has been hurt. And he's coming up against Ronan King, who should be an Undisputed WrestleZone champion one day. Will it be on the 24th? Will it be in Peterhead? Will it be at Blootoon Wrestling Extravaganza? That's the thing you gotta ask yourself. Anything can happen in wrestling. That's what long been established in the wrestling world, that we should expect the unexpected. We could see Ronan King walk out with the Undisputed Wrestling Championship. We could see Conor Malloy walk out with the Tri-County Championship. At the end of the night, we could see Flippy and Drippy holding both singles titles in WrestleZone. Absolutely possible. And it could. Blue Wrestling Extravaganza. It could happen. This has got very serious all of a sudden. It's because I had to run downstairs and go get a bloody TikTok parcel. So, yeah, this is a match that I'm excited to see. I really enjoy Ronan King. Aspen's long documented as one of my favorite wrestlers. And to see these two wrestle in the main event, like I say, expected main event, that's really exciting for me as a fan. Will we see Caleb and Connor involved? Probably. I know, that's probably goes without saying. We're going to see if Connor gets involved, Caleb will soon follow. They're not making friends in the WrestleZone, with the WrestleZone roster, are Flippy and Drippy. They've already had a little tussle on Twitter with Ted O'Keefe as part of the tag team champions. So they're not really making a lot of friends with the roster if they decide to tag people further. I think Ronan still thinks he's friends with the Foundation of the Future, but that's neither here or there. So as the main event goes, this is going to be phenomenal. It's going to be a great match. And their match at the tag team match at Grand City Showdown, it was a match you don't often see in WrestleZone. It was just less story, more moves. You know, there was a lot happening. Eyes darting all over the place. There was little. A lot of times you see WrestleZone matches, not that they take it easy, but they like to let things breathe a little bit more. Like to take a little bit of a moment's rest between moves, just for their own safety and well-being. Whereas Grand City Showdown, we saw these four just throw each other at one another in the hopes that one move would gain the win and gain that victory. So as far as predictions goes, I'm not making one because I'm bad at them. And I'm not good enough for any other match here. I'll probably do my five picks for Regal Rumble. But this is a main event match that you're seeing in Peterhead at the Palace Hotel. You know, this is a match that you probably expect to see, like I said, at an Aberdeen Anarchy, at a Regal Rumble, at a Hijinks, at a Battle of the Nations, at a Christmas Chaos. But we're getting to see it at the Palace Hotel on February 24th, which that's the caliber of matches you get to see on a quote-unquote B-show, you know? Unbelievable. I can't wait for it. Ah, wrestling. And that's it. WrestleZone, a Blootoon Wrestling Extravaganza coming to a home near you. Well, no, it's coming to the Palace Hotel near you. Peterhead, as part of association with Peterhead Community Council, Palace Hotel. Doors open 6 p.m. for VIP, 6:30 for general, 6:15 bell time for VIP, 7 p.m. for general. You get all those matches. If you pay, look at the wee poster here, £15 for VIP, you get 6 matches on the main show and 1 extra VIP match, including that triple threat Archer Green Young, which is going to be a really good match. So if you haven't paid the extra £3, I've been a bit of a dick about the extra £3, but then I'm thinking, you know, your family, if it's 3 years, that's an extra £12. It does add up, so I appreciate that. If you only go for general, you're going to miss out on that VIP bonus match, but you're going to see 6 outstanding matches on the card, including TV's Omar Muhammad versus Zach Dynamite, Foundation of the Future versus William Sterling and Damien, Captain Alan Sterling versus Mickey Vago, The Outfit versus Warriors against Low Life Entities. The WrestleZone Tri-Count Championship is on the line when Caleb Valhalla defends against Connor Malloy, and the Undisputed WrestleZone Championship is on the line when Lost Boy Aspen defends against Ronan King. There was something I was going to get a link for. I have forgotten what it was. But March 23rd and 24th, you can catch WrestleZone at Comic-Con Scotland at PNJ Live in Aberdeen. It's part of your ticket for that. Was I supposed to get the link for Comic-Con? I could do that. For Comic-Con Scotland, for Aberdeen. Let's get that, because why edit out when I can just do that? So, let's go to Comic-Con Scotland, northeast.co.uk, get your ticket for that. So they'll be performing both nights. You'll get to see quite a lot of wrestling. I think on the poster is pretty much what you're seeing on the poster behind me. So you get a lot of meet and greets, I'm sure. A lot of good wrestling fun as well. I've heard great things about the Comic-Con shows. There'll no doubt be galas coming up between Regal Rumble and Aberdeen Anarchy, probably a Training Academy show, but these have not been announced as yet, so I can't really plug any dates or tickets. But going to Ringside World, March 30th, the Regal Rumble takes place at Curl in Aberdeen. Great little venue. It's got a massive Tesco next to it. use that information as you wish. May 11th, Abri Anarchy with Gangrel at the Rich Energy Arena. I didn't see a lot when we were nearby because I went in January and it was really dark, but there was a KFC across the road. So there's some food for you. And you know me, I'm going to find the places where I'm going to eat. But no, I can't wait. This is the road to Abri Anarchy. I think I would say this is the beginning of it. Usually I would wait until Regal Rumble, but this is where you're kind of on the Christmas chaos. When I say you're on the footpath, and now you're Blootoon Wrestling Extravaganza, you're waiting to cross the road, and then Regal Rumble, you're on the road to Abri Anarchy. Can't wait. Wrestling's great. Go see a ticket. Go see a ticket. Go see a show. Whether it's WrestleZone or not, go see a wrestling show near you. Go check out swnscotland.co.uk. We've got an event card. It's not even the website address. It's swnscotland.com. I'm so amped up. Peterhead. Has anyone be so excited to go to Peterhead? I don't know. Blootoon Wrestling Extravaganza live Saturday, February 24th at the Palace Hotel in association with Peterhead Community Council. Go get a ticket. I'm going to go and lie down a little bit because I'm going to have to edit, chop things out. I sneezed during this episode. What a stupid thing. I'm 33 sneezing through podcasts. Shocking. I'm going to cut that out. I'm going to go splicey stuff in. Have a good one. This has been Billy. This has been the WrestleZone podcast. Go behave yourself. That's our catchphrase. I'm going to go. I'm going to go now. Bye.